Methwata, I say the wind. An extinct language with unknown origins, once spoken on its own island. Hello everyone, and welcome to the LangShack. In this video, we're going to talk about the Beothuk language, or the language of the island of Newfoundland, in Canada, along with some of its probable features. These people may have been the ones that the Vikings had contact with 1,000 years ago, based on where the settlement is on the island today. The Beothuk language was spoken until 1829. The only material on the language consists of 3 word lists. Even worse, many of the terms that were asked of them were objects that they had never seen before. The Beothuk language is already an extinct language, however its origins are mysterious because it is most likely a language isolate and not enough information was recorded to really attach it to any language family. A connection to the Algonquin languages has been proposed, but there is not enough information recorded to be completely sure of this connection. So the features of the language that we're going to discuss today are partially to mostly hypothetical and are based on patterns that linguists have noted. These aren't very useful, but there were very few complete strings ever recorded. Beothuk, Beothuate, good night. Chao Albuno, I have to throw your trap. Bochawi, I am hungry. Asedoit, I am sleepy. Numbers tended to end in the suffix ake, eek, or ook in oak. Some linguists believe that this k sound was actually a ch. Yasik, 1. Adyej, 2. Shandake, 3. Dobsake, 4. Ninejake, 5. Bashetake, 6. Oldzuk, 7. Adayuk, 8. Geothoduk, 9. Shanse, 10. Numbers between 11 and 19 tended to have the suffix A, followed by the number or some variant of the number. A Yagyesk, 11. A Ajike, 12. A Shaidek, 13. A Dabzek, 14. A Ninazek, 15. A Beshetek, 16. A Olduk, 17. A Adiuk, A Yothoduk, Athonut. Numbers based on the info available would indicate that the 1 would come before the 10s. Ajech, Athonut, 22. No number higher than 22 was ever recorded. The K was very common for noun formation, but also for verbs. Obesedake, gloves. Adothuk, fish hook. It is highly likely that these suffixes were diminutive forms. Aish, H, and Ish. Shuwanyish, a small vessel, comes from a noun, shuwan, meaning bucket or cup. Mamusamich, puppy, comes from a noun, mamasamate, meaning dog. Buhashamesh, boy, comes from a noun, bukashaman, meaning man. Mandawach, bushes, the form that it came from is not known. A possible plural form, ka or cha, has even been noted. Odizet, odensuk, goose or geese. Drona, dronouk, one hair or hair. Mermeuk, eyebrows. Danyad, danyadruk, bird or birds. Ejabathuk, sails. Veroich, clouds. There are other possible derivatives of nouns, but it is unknown as to their possible specific use, such as dingyam, clothes. Woldum, or wudum, pond. 8. A common nominal suffix. Tedashate, neck. Methabate, cattle. Kosweit, deer. Oret, another one. Bobusoret, codfish. Bogodoret, heart. Oldrat, fire. Ut, mokothut, fish species. Maderut, hiccup. Beothuk tended to use one or more nouns to coin new words, or compound nouns. Washgeuis, night, literally night sun. Adasweit Eishamut, December, has the word Odasweit, meaning rabbit. Kasinguingate, blind. Gaschet Gaston, the translation, dry on eyes. Bobby Dwish Emmet lamp. This one was fire oil, and I have confirmed myself that this is fire oil. Adjectives. There's not much to show here, but based on the evidence we have in the one phrase, shed basing wathik, meaning upper arm, shed basing is arm. It would appear that the adjective goes after the noun. There is no specific ending for adjectives. Bolsaik, blunt. Gasuk, dry. Ashe, lean. Homedich, good. Asoit, angry. Verbs and their usage in Beothuk is even lesser known than other parts of Beothuk grammar. However, the following observations have been noted. The infinite or verb in its ing form tend to end in t and k. Verbs ending in t, marot, to smell, moa, moadamut, to boil, amshut, to get up, be too white, to lie down. Verbs ending in k, boshodik, to bite, karumtak, to speak, ebathuk, to drink, odishwik, to cut. Although some linguists think these could be misspelled, some verbs probably ended in p and s. Athep, athes, to sit down, gamyes, to get up. Sadly, there are no standalone pronouns we know of to use these verbs with, but some possible conjugations and inflections may have been recorded. The first person singular, bochawit, I am hungry. Aoseduit, I am sleepy. Botzawit, sleep. Isedoit, to sleep. Ajedik, viedisk, I like. These other forms most likely represented other personal forms of verb conjugations. Pokudumt comes from odoit, meaning to eat. Yeruthak, or jerothak, comes from the verb karumtak, to speak. Bobasha comes from oboshin, meaning warming yourself. Possible reflexive form, perhaps? Possible participle forms of verbs. Amet, awake. Goset or galsep, dead. Aparet, sunken. Imperative forms of verbs. Many verbs look like they take the ending de and t mostly. Deud, come with us. Dut thoret, come here. Koka boset, don't be scared. Nadied, come back. But there are exceptions, obviously. Bobathuich, be him. Vehemin, give me. Question of the day. Do you believe that the Beothuk language is related to the Algonquin language group, or do you believe that it is a standalone language? I hope that you all enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about the topic or want a more in-depth discussion, let me know and I will make that. Thank you guys for watching, and catch us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook at LangShack and at LangShack.org, our official website. And support us on Patreon, patreon.com/LangShack. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.